Hello kids, today I will be briefing you all on a very important concept called law of indices. I will be covering it up in the same manner the way we have done in class, so I am sure you can relate to it. Okay, so whenever whatever doubt arises, this will be your reference point. First law of indices is what? First law is product law. Okay, product law. Now what is product law? Product law means basically multiplication. So AM into AN. What is the friend of multiplication? Addition. So what will be your indices? AM plus N. One very important point what you have to remember in indices is that the base should be always same. Then only you can implement law of indices. If base is different, then you cannot apply law of indices. So if there is a question with a number like this, a raised to 4 into a raised to 2, then what will be my answer? A raised to 4 plus a raised to 2, which is a raised to 6. I hope till here we are clear. Now what is my second law? My second law is quotient law. What is quotient law? Quotient law is in terms of division. What is the friend of division? Subtraction. So a raised to m minus n. Now if there is a question like this, a raised to 4 upon a raised to 2, then my answer will be a raised to 4 minus 2, which is a raised to 2. Are you all clear about this? Product law, quotient law. Which is third law? Third law is power law. It is power law. So this is like this. A raised to m on outside the bracket raised to n. So in case of power law, m और ब्रैकेट के बीच में कोई भी साइन नहीं है. वेन एवर नंबर और ब्रैकेट के बीच में भी कोई साइन नहीं है, इट इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन. इन द सिमिलर मैनर इन केस ऑफ इंडाइसिस, इन केस ऑफ योर इंडेक्सेस, इंडेक्सेस के बीच में भी कोई साइन नहीं है तो इट इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन. सो ए रेस टू एम इन टू एन. सो इफ इट इज लाइक दिस, ए रेस टू 4, then your answer is a raised to 4 into 2, which is a raised to 8. Are you all with me? Till here we are together. Okay, fourth row is, drill this thing in your mind. A non-zero number. Non-zero number, which means if it is a raised to 0, then your answer will be always 1. Are you with me? If it is a raised to 0, then your answer will be always 1. So any base raised to 0, answer will be always 1. So for example, if it is like this, a raised to 2 upon a raised to 2, this is quotient law. It's quotient law means division law means division ka friend is subtraction. So a raised to 2 minus 2, which is a raised to 0, which is answer is equal to 1. Till here together? Yes. Last law is called negative index. This is my last law, which is called negative index. So if it is like this, a raised to minus m, then your answer will be what? 1 upon a raised to m. Or if it is like this in the form of number, if it is like this, 2 raised to minus 1, then your answer is 1 upon 2 raised to 1, which is equal to half. Till here we are together. So the things what you have to remember is product law, which is a raised to m into a raised to n, which is a raised to m plus n, because product ka friend is multiplication, ka friend is addition. Second is quotient law. A raised to m upon a raised to n means division. Division ka friend is subtraction. So a raised to m minus n. Third is power law. A raised to m outside the bracket raised to n. Any number or any alphabet multiplied by the bracket is always no sign outside the bracket, means it is always multiplication. So a raised to m into n. Non-zero number. Non-zero number means a raised to 0 is always 1. Remember this thing. Any, in case of law of indices, any variable or any base raised to 0 will be always 1. What is your fifth index? Your fifth index is negative index. A raised to minus m is equal to a 1 upon a raised to m, because my target is to always make my negative index as positive. So whenever you have got a negative index like this, first thing what you will be doing is making it positive. So you will take this numerator into denominator. So answer is 1 upon a raised to m. And another important thing what you have to remember in case of indexes is that your base should be always similar. If your base is different, then you cannot apply law of indices. Thank you so much.